I've been printing with Siraya Tech Sculpt for about a year now, and I have used a crap ton of it. I'm up to probably close to 30 liters of Sculpt printing my injection molds for my fishing lures. So I want to share my experiences and the pluses and the minuses of using Siraya Tech Sculpt. Let's go. So first, let's talk about why you would want to use Siraya Tech Sculpt. And a lot of reasons why you don't want to use Siraya Tech Sculpt. So why you'd want to use Sculpt is super simple. It's called heat, deflection, temperature. Siraya Tech Sculpt is one of the resins that has the highest heat deflection temperature, at least in consumer level 3D printer resins. Its heat deflection temperature is 160 degrees centigrade Celsius, which comes out to about 320 degrees Fahrenheit. So we're gonna dive into heat deflection temperature in just a second, but that is the primary benefit of Sculpt. It handles high temperatures. It prints nice, its details are good, but you only really wanna use it for high temperature resistant. So let's talk about heat deflection temperature real quick. First of all, I'm not an engineer of any kind whatsoever, and I'm definitely not a materials engineer. So what I'm about to share with you is a combination of what I've been able to tell from the test that determines heat deflection temperature, as well as my own experiences. So heat deflection temperature is determined using a test where they print a standard size of the material in question. Now, a lot of people look at heat deflection temperature, in this case, 160 degrees C, as kind of like an absolute number. And that's not really true. If you print a thinner piece of Sculpt, say 1 millimeter thick, it will not be able to absorb or reach the temperature of 160 C before deforming, because it's a smaller piece of material. Conversely, when I print my molds, they're 15 millimeters thick on each side, and I have been able to inject them with 400, sometimes slightly over 400 degree plastisol. Yeah, sometimes I'm an idiot. With no real issues whatsoever. And my molds are also clamped either in a vise or with bolts, pushing them in, thus further strengthening them against any deformation from heat. So I know a lot of people get, when they're talking about fishing lures, you know, it's 350 degrees is the temperature plastisol converts to a usable product at. And a lot of people look at that 320 and they're like, oh, well, it's not gonna work. It works totally fine, even at higher temperatures, as long as your mold is made the way I make my molds. Again, 15 millimeters thick on each side. Let's talk about why you don't want to use Sculpt. If you don't need the high heat deflection properties of Sculpt, just don't use it. As you'll see coming up, it's kind of a hassle to work with. You're much better off using some other resin from Siraya Tech, fast, easy, any of the kind of normal printing resins. They're much, much easier to deal with, and they produce very, very similar results to Sculpt in terms of detail. You just don't wanna mess with it if you don't have to. Let's talk about actually printing Sculpt. One of the things that they mention in the documentation, which I've linked below, is that it wants to be above 25 degrees Celsius when you print. And yes, that is true. It wants to be above 25 degrees Celsius. But what you really want to think about is if you print it below that temperature, your exposure times are going to need to be greater. And while you're printing, the resin is actually getting warmer. And so if it crosses that threshold, if it starts at say 23 degrees Celsius, and as you're printing, it's warming up and it grows across to 26 degrees Celsius, you're going to get dramatic overexposures and your print is going to look pretty bad after it converts to that point. So really what you want to think about is stability, right? You can print it at a lower temperature as long as you can keep it lower than 25 degrees Celsius. And if you print it warmer, you just want to make sure that you start at 25 degrees Celsius or slightly above during the printing process, because it will just warm up as you're going. So they do mention that 35 C is kind of the top of the range. So if you're heating it with something that is going to produce temperatures above that range, you might have other things that happen. So keeping it, I like to keep mine right at 25 degrees C when I start, and so it warms up a few degrees while it's printing. Okay, let's talk about post-processing. My print's done, it's looking cool. Now what? And this is again where Sculpt is a little more difficult to deal with than a lot of the quote unquote normal resins. So first off, Sculpt likes to be cleaned in a very high alcohol content environment. I think they mentioned like 98% or 99% isopropyl alcohol. I ended up using denatured alcohol, and the reason for that is evaporates relatively quickly compared to isopropyl alcohol. You can also use acetone, which I did use for a while, evaporates very, very quickly, but it was very, very irritating to both my eyes and my nose. And even with a mask on, it was causing problems, right? I'd often walk off and leave the container open. I'd come back to my shop and it would just be filled with acetone fumes. Not good. So I switched to denatured alcohol and it seems to be doing pretty well. The other thing to note is that Sculpt does not want to be in any of these substances for longer than 30 seconds. It will actually start to break down and you'll kind of skim across it and it'll kind of like almost pill up, like roll up and flake, if you will. And that's when you know you had it in there too long. So my process is pretty straightforward. I take it off the printer. I wipe a lot of the excess resin off on a paper towel. Sculpt is very, very thick and it clings to the model a lot. So this rubbing takes off actually a quite large amount of Sculpt before you even get into your first cleaning. I then use a two-part clean. I have a dirty clean where I put it in there, swish it around, rub it off. I take it out and I dry it. Remember, you don't want it in there longer for 30 seconds. So I generally go about 15 seconds, take it out, rub it off, put it back in. Then it goes to a clean isopropyl alcohol bath. And this is really just to get off any of the little bits it picked up from the dirty bath. And you run it through there again, quick, maybe 15, 20 seconds, kind of lightly rub it off, pull it out, and dry it off. Now, I usually just dry it off with a paper towel and let the rest evaporate. If you want to, you can use a heat gun or a hair dryer and blow it off to get it to evaporate a little bit quicker. But you do not want it to sit on there for longer than 30 seconds. It will cause problems with your model. Now, before curing, you want to make sure it is 100% dry. It will not cure if there's any alcohol left on it at all, and you'll get incomplete cures and sticky model. You can also look at the model and see if there's any shiny parts on there. And that's also a good indication that you might not have all of the uncured resin off. Again, Sculpt is very thick. It tends to cling and hold on to models a lot. So the last step is curing, and I throw it in my cure chamber for 25 minutes. Again, the recommended time from Siraya Tech. And that seems to work just fine. If you're putting it outside, you know, you might want to have it a little bit longer. You do not want to put it in water to cure. That's not going to help Sculpt at all. So after you print one part, you're going to want to print another. So Sculpt also tends to settle in the vat. So what you want to do before even adding more Sculpt to your vat, if you're going to add more Sculpt, you want to get your little plastic scraper and kind of go back and forth across your vat lightly, because you'll see there at the bottom, there's kind of this gray film that tends to accumulate. And that's the resin settling, the polymers in the resin. They tend to go down and clump onto the FEP, and you need to get those things up and moving. If you try to print with them on the FEP, it will lead to all kinds of failures, either from underexposure, not the base layer not sticking correctly, or just it not working at all. So you give it a good stir, you get all of this, the polymer off of the bottom, off of the sides. You want to shake up your resin bottle that you're going to add quite a lot. Again, it's very thick, has a lot of polymers in there. Pour the new stuff in. I like to give it another quick swirl just to make sure it's all integrated, and then you're ready to go. This stirring also exposes the FEP to oxygen, which kind of helps it prevent it from sticking excessively and get you better release of your mold while you're printing. That's it, guys. If you want to see some of the molds I've printed with Sculpt, you can click right here. And if you want to see other people's impressions of Sculpt, I put together a playlist of everybody else's Sculpt videos right here. Take care. Tight lines.